Hello and welcome back to our channel. Today I'm going to put to a test a potato stimulating rose growth method that I've seen all throughout the internet as well as on YouTube. What this method requires, as the name suggests, a potato, a healthy budding rose stem, as well as some root growth hormone. I typically do not use root growth hormone, but in order to be fair to this method, I'm going to follow the instructions as closely as possible. I have done this in advance, and I'm going to show you my results in this video in order to be fair and as comprehensive as possible. So as you see here, you're going to create an incision in the potato. You're going to take your stem, dip it in a bit of root growth hormone, and put it into the potato. At first, I thought that this was all you had to do, and in 7 to 10 days, I noticed that the stem was blackening, the potato and the stem were rotting, and I was absolutely not seeing any root growth whatsoever. Then I did a little bit of digging, and I tried to see if there was something I was doing wrong and if I wanted to correct my method. And some videos and instructions suggested that what you want to do is actually bury the potato with the stem inside of it in a pot of soil. So that's what I did. I selected some good, healthy, and adequately mixed soil and planted my potato in that soil to see if that would help remedy the rotting and the blackening I was seeing. So I went ahead and I buried my stem and my potato in a fairly sizable pot. And in order to stimulate a greenhouse effect as well as protect the delicate leaves, I went ahead and used a glass jar, and I put the glass jar over the stem to create a greenhouse effect as well as protect it from UV damage. However, I did remove the jar occasionally to allow the stem to breathe and avoid any molding or spreading of disease that could happen if the greenhouse effect is overly maintained. So I'm going to show you the final results here. I have several stems potted in this plant potter, and I've had them potted in this plant potter for about 2 months. So I'm going to see the results. As you see, there is a little leaf right there. And unfortunately, the other stems don't seem to be looking as well. So I'm going to take a look here. And this stem appears to be completely rotted out. So that's not very promising, but we're going to go ahead and dig through the soil here just to see what the inside looks like, what is not visible to us. So we're going to go ahead and find our potato that was buried here 2 months ago. And as you see, it looks like it has been rotting quite significantly here. So the potato did in fact rot, and as you see, one of the stems, in fact the stem that looked the most promising with that little leaf on it, has completely rotted. The stem has blackened at the bottom, and although the stem seems a bit greener and healthier at the top with that leaf, it seems to be completely superficial. There is no root growth, and there's really nothing to show for it for those 2 months that we spent on this method. So it's a bit disappointing, but no worries. I do have an alternative method that you can use that is much more effective and will be much more successful and does not involve any type of gimmicky potato-related growing methods. So I'm going to go ahead and show you that real quick. For the method I prefer to use, and I've been using this method for generations, I'm going to use a simple container full of water. The reason why I don't think the potato method worked is you are essentially promoting a rotting potato to produce ethylene as it decomposes, as it rots, and that's going to inhibit tissue growth and stimulation. It's going to promote aging, and it's going to interfere with the auxins of the plant. So you want to bypass that entirely. You do not want any nasty ethylene or rotting to take place. So what you're going to do is you're going to put it into a container of water, and you're going to leave it there for 1 month. So I here used a vase. I wanted to make sure that there was water present at all times. You don't have to overfill it. You just have to ensure that the bottom of the stem is touching the water. You do not need to rely on root growth hormone. I prefer not to. If you wish to do so, that is entirely up to you. I did not. And as you can see, there is healthy root growth happening simply by passing this method entirely. So we're going to take that stem and we're going to plant it in this here potting planter. Once you have seen that there is healthy root growth, just take it and transplant it, and you can once again rely on that greenhouse method. As I have already mentioned, you do not need to use root growth hormone. In fact, the results are much better without it. The roots grow quicker, faster, and at a healthier, more natural rate. You can take a glass jar, put it over your plant to simulate the greenhouse effect. Once again, I do recommend removing it to prevent any molding or spreading of infection or disease or any harm to the plant. Do remove it on occasion to let it breathe. And that is essentially all you have to do in order to get a healthy rose bush at the end of all of this. You do not need to use any potatoes or any type of tactics. All you need is a little bit of patience, a glass vase, and some water. Thank you so much for watching. If you have any recommendations or suggestions regarding the potato method, if I was doing something wrong, please let me know below. Thank you, and I hope to see you again soon.